Hello folks, and welcome here to Holiday World of Katy at Katy, Texas. I'm going to show you today the Cougar High Country 337. It's a brand new floor plan and truly a beautiful coach, and obviously a truly beautifully built coach because it's Cougar. This is now the number one selling fifth wheel in the country now as a mid-profile. I'd like to start you off straight away here in the storage baggage area. We have a full pass-through storage area in the front. Inside you can see the Weber electric grill that comes with it, and also the roll of 50 amp cable. This is a true 50 amp trailer. It means that you can run everything all at the same time. The slide out here is wire pulled and pushed. That's a bit technical, but it helps keep down the weight. The weight on this trailer is under 10,000 pounds. It makes it very easily towed with a 3/4 ton diesel or a 3/4 ton gas. Around we go a little bit further. Opening up the cabinetry here, you can see just one gas bottle, but on the other side, there's another gas bottle. They have a semi-automatic transfer switch on them. Putting one each side also helps with the balance of the trailer. Let's go around to the front now. Here you can see we have a full fiberglass cap. This is not one of the plastic lookalikes, it is indeed a true molded fiberglass cap. You may say that it's got a rather unusual shape, and that shape is for aerodynamics. And look, this cutout here allows you to do turns that you wouldn't normally be able to do when you're backing up with the trailer. We have a very good pin box here that's extended. This helps with the tongue weight, helps reduce the tongue weight. Behind it here is another compartment. It's mainly for an outdoors, but you can in fact fit a generator in here if you so desire. The battery is also in here as well. You can see the legs underneath the trailer here. They're electrically powered. Something very special about this trailer that it does have the auto leveling system, which I'll show you as we go further around the trailer. Let's wander on round to the other side now. Down on this side, you can see we have another slide room here, and here is the wire control unit. But very importantly underneath, I don't know if you can see them well, but there's Teflon rollers underneath here. This makes the slide out operation extremely smooth. None of that jugger, jugger, jugger that you hear with many of the other kinds. Very smooth. And of course we have here the water seals to make sure that when the trailer goes in on a rainy day, you wipe all the water off here. But unlike a lot of our competition, we don't have one single wiper. But if you look inside here, there's another wiper. And behind that is a C-channel. So if you should get any water pass through the first one or pass through the second one, then indeed it hits the C-channel and comes out through the bottom. Very, very important. The second gas bottle, as I pointed out before, is on this side. So it balances, complements the weight of the trailer. Beautifully balanced trailer, this one. On the other side of that big compartment that I showed you before is the back side of it here. There's a small toolbox area built into the front underneath the main floor. But critically important to me is this area here. This is what we might call the potty control works. We have hot and cold running shower here, city water connection, sewer flusher, and a battery disconnect. Battery disconnect is a wonderful thing if you leave your trailer for any time at all. In here we have the main freshwater tank fill. The tank is approximately 60 gallons of fresh water. Of course, we don't travel with that if we don't need it. That's a lot of weight you don't need to do. But this is a locked compartment. You don't want anybody putting sugar or something in your fresh water. And yet another slide. This is three slides so far. The same wire control, keeping the weight down. And above it, we have the drip trays. If you do get water on the side, it comes away from the side instead of running down the side here. While we're talking about the side, you can see this high polished gel coat finish with these nice decals on. Very attractive. A big slide room, this one. We come down here now to the inspection hatch for the refrigerator. If you should have any problems with the refrigerator at any time, any work that needs to be done can be right here. We don't have to pull the refrigerator out to do it. Come on, follow me around. Up here we have the water heater. This is a 6-gallon fast reaction water heater. And in fact, we'll give you about 10 gallons of hot water and refills very, very quickly, reheats very quickly. And here is the exhaust for the furnace. Pan on down now, Mr. Cameraman, and let's have a look at these wheels. They're 16-inch with E-grade tires. Each wheel has its own set of brakes on it. So when you are using your brakes in conjunction with a brake controller, you in fact have eight sets of brakes all working at the same time. And now the important thing, or one of the important things, right here is a leveling jack. At the press of a button, literally, we can self-level this trailer. This is normally found on only the very big Highline fifth wheels, but here we are with the Highline mid-profile fifth wheel with the same system. Makes life very, very interesting. Your sewer connections are right underneath here. Obviously, connect up before you run the slide out. It's simplicity itself. When you do your walkthrough, after you've made your purchase, technician will of course take you all through the systems. It takes about an hour and a half, your school, and you'll learn every nut and bolt and how it all works inside the trailer. Come on round to the back end now with me. Round at the back end of the trailer here, you can see we have a ladder that goes up onto the roof. And many people say, well, why do you need a ladder? Well, there's two or three reasons. One, of course, if you need to do any roof maintenance. I myself am a NASCAR fan. We go to Texas Motor Speedway twice a year, and we are on the infield, so it's nice to be able to get up on the roof. But to give us even more confidence, we know that this is a full walk-on roof. In fact, we've had, you know, six, seven, eight people up on the roof of mine with the cool boxes, chairs, tables, and everything else. No problem whatsoever. Down here at the back, and you can't see it too well here, but there's a full pull-out tray that comes out 2 feet. It's got a 200-pound carrying capacity, and it's ideal for that portable generator or a big ice box, you know, if you're going away for one of those dry camping weekends. Very, very good system indeed. On the back here, of course, is the spare tire in its own little cover. Well, here we go round again to another slide. As you can see, now this trailer has four slides. It gives an immensely large interior to the trailer, which I know you're all bursting to see. So what we're going to do now is wander off to the front door here and show you that. But before we go right there, there's yet another storage compartment here. This is underneath one of the beds, and every little bit of storage you can get, especially on the interior, is very, very useful. Come on around now and we'll head towards the front door. But as we get there, you can see that there's a big awning here, runs about 18 feet long, that covers the front door itself. And these huge frameless windows here give you a fabulous view from the inside. As you can see, it's blacked out. You can't see on the inside of the trailer, but you can look out as clear as day. We have a three-step entry into the coach. And here, we have a keyless entry. When you pick your number, you can select that number yourself, put it in. It's much better than having, you know, sort of half a dozen keys to half a dozen people. They just have to remember a simple number. Very, very good system. Here is an assist handle. I call it, you'll need it later handle, because I don't know about you, but I get a little older and better looking every day. But certainly something very useful for the future. I'd like to invite you in now, and we'll try and find our campground hostess who's here with us somewhere. Her name is Tinkerbell, and she'll show you around the inside of the trailer. Come on in, folks. One of the most important facets of any trailer, of course, is the kitchen. When I come in here, this sort of reminds me of an old English farmhouse. It's beautifully laid out. The color of the woods, very deep, very rich. Work surface here is a solid surface, not a formica type, but absolutely solid, with two stainless steel two stainless steel sinks, and an expanding hot and cold water here. Very nice, just like being at home. As for storage, well, it's everywhere. This coach doesn't look just pretty. It's extremely well fitted out, very well thought out. As you can see, this is all nice, nice wood. It's all solid wood. There's no plastique, that French wood. Here we have the refrigerator, a 6 cubic foot with a freezer. And the refrigerator part itself. Normally this is when Tinkerbell gets excited, because she's used to finding things in the fridge, but this one's empty. This is electrically powered and propane powered. We go along a little further. Here is the stove. It's a 3-burner with a high capacity burner at the front, with a full 22-inch oven. Many of our competitors have only 16s or 18s. This is a full 22. Above that, of course, we have the hood, which is with a powered fan and light, and even more storage. The Advent microwave is seated alongside it. You can see that it's not high, so the shorter people and the ladies can actually reach in easily without having to stretch out. Once again, we have these nice solid countertops, and yet again, more and more storage behind these solid wooden doors. The actual main pantry is here, with shelves on either side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sets of shelves there. Very, very nice. Nice click hinges and catches, so they remain closed. How about the dining room table? It's a 4-seater, solid wood once again, with an extension leaf that comes up. It's a little stiff at the moment. That comes up to give you plenty of room for either playing cards or for eating. Big panoramic window here with beautiful shades. This is the daytime shade, and here is the nighttime shade. You can immediately see, you know, the difference in the amount of light that comes in. These shades are also part of your insulation package. If you've got the sun beating down here and you bring down this daylight package, it stops the sun coming through, stops any fading of your furniture. And now, the coup de grace of this particular trailer, I'm going to take you to the front living area. And of course, here we have all the comforts of home. This is a front living trailer. As you can see, we're up in now in the front end of the trailer. Normally this would be the bedroom. We have two slide rooms here. I'm sitting on a very comfortable couch here with little old Tinker. This also makes into a bed. On my left hand side, of course, more and more of that magic storage that is so essential in your travel trailer, especially if you're going to do extended staying or even full time, because you could use this as a full time. We have an electric fireplace here with what we call a log glow effect. Very nice, you know, those flickering flames, but it's actually a heat source and very, very nice. Big TV. This TV can also be pulled out and turned at angles. So if you're sitting on one side of this living unit, of course, you can see the TV quite comfortably. On the other side, and I'll wander over there slowly. You ready to move over sofas? Come on, let's go over to the other one. We have yet again more storage on this side, on both sides, and another huge L-shaped couch. We have lights here that are very romantic, isolation lights, very nice, and then the regular TV lights. Dinky, come over here. There's a good girl. She loves the comforts of home, this little dog. She's our hero at the moment because a couple of days ago she caught her first rabbit. So as Elvis Presley would say, now she can be a friend of mine, can't you, huh? All right. Beautiful carpentry, beautiful carpets. The whole thing is just like a home, even with the wrought iron rails in the front here to stop the dog falling over into the kitchen area. We're going to head off now to the bathroom and then the bedroom. The bedroom is really sensational, and so is the bathroom. So you ready, Miss Tinker? Let's go show everybody the bathroom, okay? Come on, let's go. Okay, and here we are in the bathroom. Nice big medicine cabinet here with a large mirror for the ladies or for the gentlemen. A couple of good sized shelves with some hidden lighting up here. Good sized sink, hot and cold running water. 2 110-volt plug-ins here with a GFI on it and the light switch above. The shower's a very good size. Excuse me, Tinker. She hates the shower at home, so I don't know why she's even standing here. There's a good sized shower. Even, you know, the largest of folks can get in there and happily turn around. Good supply of hot and cold running water as well. For the towels and such things, very big closet here, or very big cabinet. I don't know if our cameraman can get in there to show it to you, but it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 shelves in here. Nice deep shelves. Getting around to the potty, of course, which is quite an important piece of furniture, but it's a porcelain one. None of this, you know, plastic stuff here. It's a proper marine toilet with a foot pedal flush. Above us here we have a air extraction fan. Get ready of any of those little nasties. And a set of double lights above. Plenty of light, plenty of air circulation. It's a double door bathroom, as you can see. I've just come in through this door. Now I'm going to walk into the bedroom. So you can take a shower in there, come out here, just in your towel or your robe, and dry off. Get yourself dressed. Here's the main door for the bedroom. So if you do have guests, you don't have to expose yourself to your guests. You just come literally through this door here. Once again, no shortage of cabinetry and closets. We have a hanging closet here with a good size rail, and down underneath two very deep shelves. Coming around to this side now, once again, two overheads. Very deep. These are not the typical sort of 10 inches deep, they're a full 14 inches. Plenty of storage in there. Six drawers down on the bottom end. They're all on metal runners with ball bearings, so they're nice and smooth. They don't jam, but they will stay closed when you're traveling along the road, and there's six of those. There's a TV hookup right here, so that bedroom TV can be just plugged in, either mounted here or sometimes on one of the walls, but this would be the best spot. A matching closet to the one on the other side. Full length once again. Wonderful. A good window on the back, which we'll try and pan into. It's also an escape hatch. You know, in the event of something wrong, it's possible to open this and the whole frame and window comes out. Once again, you have that night and day shade effect for total privacy. There are two more windows at the head of the bed. I know some people like a little bit of light, others like it dark. You can completely black this out with the day shades. And above the bed, once again, even more and more and more storage. Underneath the bed itself, there's more storage. My goodness me, how much storage could you possibly need? A good size compartment right there. And that is also matched up with the outside compartment that I showed you earlier. The bed's spring loaded, so it's easy up and easy down. Beautiful firm mattress, not your normal RV mattress. This is in fact a pillow top. Very good quality, very comfortable. As you come in through the main door, the lights are here to master your switch. This unit has one 15K air conditioner, which is huge, and more than enough to, you know, keep this trailer cool. Should you decide to have a second, it can be fitted right here. It's already pre-wired. All we have to do is take that cap off and mount an air conditioner there. With all the comforts of home, we're happy to offer this trailer to you either for long-term, full-time, or even for just, you know, those long weekends or trips to the lake or the coast. My name is Croc, incidentally, Croc O'Dial, the man from Down Under. And this is my right-hand person. This is Tinkerbell. She's our unofficial campground hostess. And of course, we are full-time RVers and have been for more years than I can even think about telling you. That's why I'm so happy to show this quality of unit. It's the sort of unit that full-timers, people like myself, people with a lot of experience, are happy to purchase because they know they have a good quality unit that can tolerate the bumps and groans in the road and still give you all the luxury and comforts of your home. So if this is something I can show you in person, I'd be more than happy to. You can call me on our 800 number, actually it's our 281 number. That's 281-371-7200. Just ask for the crocodile or the man down under or Tinkerbell's dad, and I'll be more than happy to show you around. We're open 6 days a week, Monday through Saturday, but I personally am only here Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. I'm sort of semi-retired now. So if you'd like to call in and make an appointment, I'd be more than happy to look after you. So from me, Croc O'Dial, my proper name's Gary, but nobody calls me that, and my little girl, Miss Tinkerbell, wish you all the very best. Happy camping. Please, when you call in, don't forget to ask for me. Oh, incidentally, if we do business, I personally offer a free weekend's camping at a friend of mine's campsite down in Sargent. It's a brand new campsite down there, and you can go down there and enjoy a couple of nights free of charge and really enjoy yourself and get used to your new camper. So from myself, Croc O'Dial, my little girl Tinkerbell, from all of us here at Holiday World, Katie, we wish you all the very best. Bye for now.